Sometimes when you generate chord progressions inside the grid of Bitwig Studio, you come across a problem where you have notes outside of your current octave, which is not a bad thing, but sometimes your chords are too far apart and you need some kind of feature where you can automatically group your chords closer together. And you can do this manually by using inversions. You basically pitch some of these notes one octave lower, two octaves lower or higher, and so on. But we want to do this automatically. So we basically want to create some kind of wave folder for pitches. So we have our working octave in where we start our chord progression, and then all the octaves above this octave and below this octave are basically folded back together. Our current working or starting octave. It sounds more complicated than it is, and I'll show you in a minute how it looks like in the piano roll, and also after that how we can make this feature work inside the grid. Okay, so let's start. So this is how it looks like in the piano roll of Bitwig Studio, and you can see here this chord progression starts with the root note of C3, and our current octave is basically ranging from C3 to C4. And only the last chord here has a note out of this octave, right? And to bring these chords closer together, you probably would just select this note here and pitch it 12 semitones down. In Bitwig, it's basically just shift, holding shift and arrow down. And you can bring this back to the same key, just one octave lower. And manually, this is not a problem because you have access to all these notes here on the piano roll. But when you actually create chord progressions within the grid automatically or randomly, then it's not so easy. So for this example, I completely skip the step of generating the notes. I go straight here for a pitch in, so we can use the MIDI keyboard or the piano roll to actually try this out. And as the next module, I'm gonna go here for a readout so we can see which note we are playing. And I already have here some notes in my clip, which is C3 and D3, okay? So now we can see this here, C3 and D3. Nice. So we have our notes in the grid. And then I'm going for an pitch to octave. This is what we need. And for this, we need an oscilloscope to see what's going on here. So basically what this module does or says wraps pitch signals octave as phase signal. So what this means is that you can generate a phase signal, which is just a ramp, as you can see here, by using the octave. So when we play here in this piano roll, all the keys of our current octave, we get a phase signal out of this. So this should work. So you can see the first note is always zero, which is C, and the last note, which is B of our octave, generates a signal of one. So we can basically get a phase signal out of our current octave. And when we move this here up to the next octave, so just pitch this up to C4 and play this again, it's exactly the same outcome. So it doesn't matter for this module which octave we are using. It's always generating a phase signal from 0 to 1. So this is nice. All we have to do now is to use and scalar, but this time a pitch scalar, which basically pushes our possibilities down to one octave, C3 to C4. So we basically have from every octave we play a signal from 0 to 1. This goes into the pitch scaler, which basically makes only notes possible between C3 and C4. So every note we are playing now is in the range of C3 and C4, okay? When we don't use this module before and just go straight into this here, this is not gonna work. Because the pitch scaler always pushes everything down. So it basically takes all the octaves available in Bitwig and pushes them or squeezes them down to one octave. So most of these keys are not the same keys afterwards. So we need to have this pitch to octave module here in between. It basically generates only a signal for one octave. So now we have this in place. That's basically all we have to do. We can now use here an oscillator. Let's use a sine, ADSR, and one out, and go here straight into the pitch. And now when we're gonna play this here, doesn't matter where we play this. We always are in the same octave between C3 and C4. So we are, when we basically exceed C4, we are back at C3 again, okay? So this means we can now generate, let's switch this here to polyphonic mode, can create chord progressions. Go back here to C3, okay? Make this a bit quieter. You can see we already have this chord corrected here. So basically this note becomes this note and this note becomes this note, okay? So you can group these notes closer together without having to go in actually and move these chords manually. Okay, so this is the example of the piano roll, but inside the grid, when you generate, you probably don't need this when you generate notes, but when you have generate notes, you go into the pitch to octave scaler here, use the pitch scaler, and then you have all your notes in one octave grouped together. And that's sometimes extremely helpful, as I said in the beginning, when you create chord progressions on the fly and you want to have all your notes of these chords close together. So this is a trick you can use. I found out for myself it's pretty helpful, and I probably make some examples with it in my next patches. Another tip I want to throw in that has nothing to do with this tutorial whatsoever is maybe throw in here a multiply and multiply it with a constant of -1, which basically inverts all your pitch signals or makes your keyboard, in this case, our keyboard, turns your keyboard upside down, so it gets you out of your muscle memory zone and gives you new harmonies from your old habits of pressing the same notes over and over again. So this is just a small tip. Inverting the keyboard here with the multiply and constant of -1, it's interesting. Yeah, that's it for this video. And before you start to ask, you can use my note grid out preset to actually route this note information out of the grid into your synth, but only in a monophonic way. There's actually no way to output polyphonic note informations out of the grid to other synthesizers of VSTs inside Bitwig. Sadly, we have to wait for this feature a bit longer. Hopefully not too long. Yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please leave a comment if you have some questions, leave a thumbs up if you like the video, subscribe to the channel to be notified about new videos, and maybe think about subscription here on YouTube with the membership or over on Patreon, and you also get some nice gifts for it. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Stay safe and bye.